Hello friends, my name is Priyendra Kumar. In this video, you will learn how we can create Excel to PDF file using VBA. So friends, it is quite easy to save an Excel file as PDF. You just need to save as and just save it as PDF. But when you have multiple file or hundreds file in a folder which have to be converted into PDF, then you have to open each and every file and save as PDF. So it will take quite long time. I have created a macro to convert multiple files to PDF. Now here I have two link. One is Excel folder path. This is the folder wherein I have multiple Excel files. And the second is PDF folder path. Once the files will be converted into PDF, it will be available in this folder. So this is the PDF files. You can see it is blank. And these are the Excel files, these 10 Excel files. Now let me show you the macro. If I will click on convert Excel to PDF, then you can see this processing here. So it is converting the Excel file to PDF. Now it's completed. Now let me show you the PDF file. So you can see here we have 10 files. You can open any file and you can see the result. Okay, so basically this macro has converted these 10 files into PDF on single click. Now we will learn how we can create this macro. So let's start. I'm going to add a new workbook here and I will copy this path, paste this here. Okay, now I'll go to the developer tab, Visual Basic, and here I will insert a module. So go to the insert and module. Here I'll write my code sub. Okay, now first of all I'll define the worksheet, dim sh as worksheet, and then set sh equal to this workbook dot seats. And I know the seat one is my seat wherein I have pasted the path. Okay, now here first of all I'll go to the tools and reference. I will add a reference here and that reference will be Microsoft scripting runtime. So just check that reference and click on OK. If this reference is not available here, you can just scroll it down and it will be available somewhere here. So click on OK. Now we have added Microsoft scripting runtime. Now here I'll take the FSO as new file system object. Then I'll take one more variable, dim FO as folder. Then dim F as file. Okay. Now I'll also take an integer, dim N as integer to get the count of files. Now here take dim WB as workbook. Set FO equal to FSO dot get folder, and here we will give the folder path. So folder path we will connect it with the Excel sheet. So I'll go to the Excel sheet. This is the Excel file path which is on E2. You can see here ss.range E2.value. Now here we will put a loop for each f is the file in fo.files. Alright, so first of all what we will do, we will take n value of n equal to n plus 1, and we are using just to check the current processing of the files in status bar. So first of all what we will do here, we will make the status bar visible in the starting application dot display status bar equal to true, and we also use application dot screen updating false. We don't want to update the screen. Now here what we will do, we will use application dot status bar equal to, in the status bar it will display processing and then the current number of file which will be n, and we will use the slash sign and then fo.files.count. Alright, Now what we will do, we will open the first file set wb equal to, here we will use workbooks.open. Now the first file will be, each time it will be f, okay, so f.path. If we will use f.path, then it will give the complete path including the file name and extension. Okay, so it will open this file. Once this file is opened and assigned to wb, then we will use wb.export as fix format. Then here we will use space and then Excel type PDF. Okay, then we will use the file name. Now the file name, first of all we need to give the file path. So file path will be, we are using here this, the PDF file path, so which is on E3. So ss.range E3.value, then slash, and then the file name. So here in place of slash, you also can use application.path separator, and then the file name. So file name will be f.name, but this file name will be including extension. For example, the file name is test1, then it will return test1.xlsx. So we will change the xlsx as PDF. Okay, so what we will do, we will use vba.replace here and the file name. So we will find the extension as xlsx and we'll change it with the .pdf. That's it. And now at the last, we will close this workbook, wb.close. Okay, now once this loop is completed, all the file converted into PDF, then we will use application.statusbar equal to blank, and here we can put some message like process completed or any other message, whatever you want. Now let me go back to the Excel file. Just go to the insert, go to the shapes, and just insert a rectangle here. You can put any text, let's say. Now right click here, assign macro, select this workbook and select the macro which we have created. Now just check, click on convert Excel to PDF. So first we will delete these files. Now this PDF folder is blank. Now click on this, so you can see the processing here. Now the all the files has been converted. Now we can go to the PDF folder and we can see. So friends, it's quite easy. You can use it to convert your multiple files like 100,000 Excel files into PDF file on one click. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please practice this, it is quite easy. Thank you so much for watching.